some fellas. Please, mister. We gotta do something. Help! Help me!
There we go. Bad day for you, mister.
Hey, look out!
You don't mind.
What in
you?
The heck?
Out of the damn way!
What's all this? Help! Somebody help! Oh, God! Oh, God!
Petrov?
Yeah.
Hey, Arthur.
Come on! If we're gonna make it to this party, we sure as shit better clean up a little.
So we're doing this?
Oh, yeah. Old friend Dutch van der Linde is finally showing his true colors. Social climbing.
Old Signor Bronte, that horrendous snake, has invited us to the ball, Cinderella. So my suggestion is we go and get you a gown.
You son of a bitch!
Utterly.
I ain't never been to a ball in my life.
Nor have I, if I am being honest.
I used to quite often. There can be fine pickets.
Oh, no pickpocketing. We are here to make real contact.
What kind of contact?
Well, I don't know. We'll find what we can. All I know for sure is we are going to a party at the mayor's house, and the guest of honor is the worst crook in town. I am sure that we will find something.
Okay.
Gentlemen, Luca. I'm afraid the mayor does not allow guns at official functions after last year's incident. Luca here will take you to Mr. Bronte. I believe he is expecting you.
Follow me, gentlemen. This way, please, gentlemen. Signor Bronte will be so pleased that you made it.
We are honored to be here.
That's wonderful, wonderful. Come this way. What a beautiful evening it shall be. Mr. Bronte is a very good friend with the mayor. Good evening, Pierre.
Signor Napoli?
As long as the mayor behaves himself, you know. Mr. Bronte, he has that thing, you know. Respect.
Jose, Bill, you join the party. We'll meet you out back after we pay our respects to Signor Bronte.
Gunga?
We'll meet you out on the balcony when you're done.
Cowboys, you've arrived. And you've washed per la prima volta questo mese senza dubbio.
This is quite a party you've invited us to.
Yes, quite something. Although I'm not quite sure what.
So, this is Saint Denis High Society.
Yes, apparently so.
And all these people, these are friends of yours, Signor Bronte.
No, not quite. But they certainly are afraid of me. Like that one. See, that wretch is the mayor. Henri Lemieux. He'll do anything for a dollar, and I mean anything.
Politics is a foul business. Yes.
Oh, and that one, too. That is Alberto Fusar. He owns a sugar plantation out on the island, and he comes here to whore and despoil himself. Oh, and that is Hobart Crawley, a Confederate major in the war. I mean, hero, they say, but this is his very young wife. I mean, a young mistress, that's the natural order of things. Yes, but a young wife is unseemly.
Oh, the Redskins. I have no sympathy for them, because whoever is stupid enough to get tricked by the Americans, no, they get what they deserve, huh? Yes, hand a letter to the mayor. Oh, yeah, that'll save you. And that is Hector Fellows. This self-righteous newspaper man. Maybe you will kill him for me one day.
Well, we're not paid killers as such. Not in cold blood, anyway.
I did not know you were so particular that you wouldn't help a friend.
Oh, I'm willing to help in any way I can, within reason.
I'm going to pretend to understand what that means.
I meant no offense, sir.
None taken. None taken! All these vulgar people. They hate me. Non vedo l'ora di guardarti morire.
Well, it has been wonderful conversing with you, but I can tell that you are very...
...and mingle with this vulgar scum. It'll make you long for the days when you could shoot each other and screw cows out on the open range.
Those sure were the days. Good day, gentlemen.
Good day to you. But before you go, what exactly are your plans here?
Well, we've not made any... Well, we are going to need some money.
Money, yes, of course. Well, there's money at the trolley station. They keep a lot of cash there in the day. Now, I could not involve myself in such matters. But you, as a guest, yes, as my guest, bah, do it, huh? Okay, good day, gentlemen.
Goodbye.
Ok ragazzi, adesso il vino buono.
Sì. I'll show you to the party, gentlemen, if you'll kindly follow me. Gentlemen, enjoy your evening and welcome once again to Saint-Denis. Ciao, ciao.
Gentlemen, let's go ingratiate ourselves.
Bonsoir, monsieur.
Okay. Go find the mayor if you can and stay out of trouble and steal nothing unless it's information.
Of course.
Jose. You go find us someplace to rob. Bill?
I mean, the modern art is all very well, but my...
How's the show? I heard you went.
Outrageous. These dancers.
Hello.
if that's French culture for you, sign me up for French lessons.
Was it just dancing?
No.
Good evening, mister.
He reminds me of someone at Book by Ball.
Would you like tickets?
What?
Sir. Camilla McClure.
Can I help you, sir?
Mew, this intellectual here was just insulting me regarding the Redskin.
I did no such thing.
But,
Mr. Lemieux, I suggested that all of us as Americans had a duty to take care of people living in this land, and that extends to Saint-Denis.
It ain't complex, Lemieux. And only an idiot like you, buddy, would try to make it so.
I will not deny idiocy, sir, but perhaps now is not the time.
Typical pansy!
You are drunk, Ferdinand.
I'm not drunk, you fool. But this man loves darkies.
Hey, you are pretty drunk. Yeah, what say you and me cool off?
Hello?
Me.
Come on, sleep it off. Sit down and calm down. Count to a thousand.
Allegedly.
There's quite a place you got here.
It's not mine, and the city is horribly in debt, but we can still put on a good show. Do you know Evelyn Miller?
My lord. The writer?
Well, we seem to have another deranged drunkard on our hands.
Shall we?
My lord, they're fantastic.
Hello, mister.
What is wrong with you?
Everything's fine. We have the place well secured.
Good.
Mr. Bronte has a habit of wandering about and reading whatever he likes.
We're watching him and his men like hawks.
Thank you, Mr. Terrapin.
Hey! Everything taken care of? The telephone, it keeps ringing.
The mayor said he will sign later.
Marie! Marie! Find that little reprobate Jip and beat him! I will not...
I'm sorry, sir, but the party is in the garden. The residence is purely for family. I do hope you understand.
Forgive me. I was unaware.
Not have standard slip in this house. Have you lost your mind? I said, have you lost your mind? Come here. Come here. Look at me. Look. At me. Who do you think you are? This area is not meant for the likes of you. You know this. Standards in this house are slipping. This is a final warning to you, miss. A final warning. Now get out of my sight.
Mr. Leviticus Cornwall. Top secret. Extremely confidential. Thank you.
Find anything?
I think so.
Gentlemen, I think we're done here.
What did you find out?
There's plenty of money moves through here, of course, and I think I found out how we can grab some of the big bank. Real one, I mean. But not yet.
A city bank?
Maybe. And a stuffed one. If we're gonna leave, that could be the one thing we need.
There's also that trolley car station Senor Bronte told us about, and I heard about a high-stakes poker game. Come on.
Here comes Lenny.
All right. Let's get in.
Go home!
Oh, I ain't never felt so awkward in all my life. All them folk also...
Interesting times.
I guess. So what's next?
My dear Arthur, I hope this letter finds you. I wanted to thank you for your help with Jamie. He and Daddy are still arguing, but I understand.
Uncle Arthur?
You settling back in?
I like it here. Lots of places to explore.
and me again, girl. Let's go, girl. Yeah. Easy now. Easy. You're okay.
You're in this state for the federal government. You're an enemy of this state. You know why you're here, don't you?
Stay back!
Oh, good. Please. Thank you.
Yeah.
I'm not sure if this is a rumor or not, but they said the Cornwall Railroad and Central Union are in a big fight.
Caretaker is a witch.
Good to see you again.
He keeps crying.
I'm sorry.
Well, sir?
Are you idiot?
Good-looking horse there. If you want me to keep that overnight, there's room in the stable.
Hope some federal comes through. I ain't seen blood in a while. That old geezer ought to drop dead. Just slowing this militia down.
good to have one of those. I got one of them myself. Always good to have one of those.
How goes, partner?
It's nice to give a little special grooming. Look after your horse good. Be damn sure it'll look after you. Enjoy. Nice bit of grooming. People take notice. That's a good-looking horse now. Yep. I'd steer clear of the women folk in this town. He's either too churchy or liable to get you itching.